We've all heard the story that autism is on the rise. It seems everyone has an opinion on why. Some blame vaccines, some blame parents. So what's really behind the rise in autism? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Autism is a widely misunderstood condition. It's a neurodevelopmental condition which frequently causes a spectrum of behaviors, like problems with social communication and repetitive and restricted patterns of behavior, like lining up toys in a row. But it's a spectrum. Individuals with the disorder have a wide range of abilities and levels of functioning. But as individual as the condition is, there does seem to be a common theme. It's much more common now than it was in years past. For the past few decades, the rate of those diagnosed with autism has been steadily on the rise. In the 1970s and 1980s, about 1 out of every 2,000 children had autism. Now, a new U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention survey published in November 2015 of parents found that 1 out of 45 kids have the condition. So what's behind the rise? Part of the rise can be explained by simple greater awareness. After a 2014 CDC study, director of the National Center on Birth Defects and Developmental Disabilities, Colleen Boyle, noted that the rise could be explained by a greater awareness in the community around autism and a better training of education and medical professionals. With this most recent survey, the CDC suggests that the rise in rates is mostly due to a change in the questions parents were asked. The CDC surveyed more than 11,000 families and asked them if a health professional ever told them that their child had autism, Asperger's disorder, pervasive developmental disorder, or autism spectrum disorder. This wording was a noticeable change from previous surveys because it specifically asked about Asperger's. You see, Asperger's is no longer in diagnostic manuals. It hasn't been since 2013. It's now folded under the umbrella of autism spectrum disorder. And this changing of diagnoses and categorization of learning disabilities is what other research indicates is responsible for most of the rise in cases of autism. Another study published in the American Journal of Medical Genetics Part B, Neuropsychiatric Genetics, found that the rise is partly the result of students being moved from one category to another, and not just from Asperger's to autism, but a shift from a diagnosis of intellectual disability to a diagnosis of autism. The study found that in just a 10-year period from 2000 to 2010, diagnoses of autism rose from 93,000 in 2000 to 419,000. But at the same time, diagnoses of intellectual disabilities fell from 637,000 to 457,000. So basically, the findings of studies like this show that the number of kids diagnosed with brain development problems hasn't changed all that much. It's really a shift in diagnosis. And shifting a diagnosis is pretty smart from a parent's perspective. For starters, autism is becoming more socially acceptable than intellectual disability. But more importantly, communities and schools have so many more resources now that we know more about autism and how powerful early intervention is. Several studies, like one published in the Journal of the American Academy of Child and Adolescent Psychiatry, found that autism-specific one-on-one intervention in toddlers with the condition improves their intellectual ability and reduces their symptoms. And that kind of treatment could come with a hefty price tag, but thankfully, most medical insurance companies are now required to cover mental and developmental conditions the same way as any other medical conditions. So we're living in an age where resources are widely available and covered by insurance. So it's in the parents and the child's best interest to get the correct diagnosis as early as possible, which, thanks to organizations like the Autism Society raising awareness, more kids are getting the help they need. So no, vaccines aren't the reason you've heard so much about autism lately. It's because of greater awareness, which is a good thing. But if you're curious about how that whole autism vaccine link got started, check out this video right here.
Still, today, when we're afraid and ill-informed, it's human instinct to assume that somebody is in the bushes and that their intent is bad. In the end, even education does fail to help. People prefer the complex narrative that they've invented over reality.
All right, guys, got any other questions about modern medicine? Leave them down below and we might answer them in a future episode. While you're here, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single DNews episode.